Good evening, everybody. A very warm welcome to the virtual celebrations with the people with cerebral palsy, parents and SSK family. We children, parents and staff at the Spastics Society of Karnataka are much obliged to invite you to observe International Day of Persons with Cerebral Palsy and a millions of reasons to celebrate this day. World Cerebral Palsy Day is a moment of people with cerebral palsy and their families and the organizations that supports them. Our vision is to ensure that children and adults with cerebral palsy have the same rights, access, and equal opportunities as anyone else in our society. It is only together that we can make that happen. We want you to help us to create an awareness and want to hear from you. What is your reason for speaking up and celebrating World Cerebral Palsy Day? Yes, there are millions of reasons.
Lalita, can you unmute yourself?
Sorry for the disturbance. It happens, all right? We had a starting problem, some issues, and we wanted one of our very old students to enter, make an entry. So hence the delay. All right. Now the curtain raises for the spectacular program by the people with cerebral palsy, their parents and professionals from SSK. Ladies and gentlemen, Priyanka Uday Kumar, a student from SSK, will flag off the event, Millions of Reasons, World Cerebral Palsy Day, with a beautiful smile. And her mother, Padma Uday Kumar, an enthusiastic person, will express few words and tell all of us her reason for speaking up and celebrate this day. Padma, Priyanka Uday Kumar will flag off this event.
Padma. I'm mother of Priyanka. This is Priyanka. She is a young adult diagnosed with cerebral palsy. We are blessed to have her in our life. She's brought a big transformation to the family. I've learned to appreciate the small joys of life. She spreads joy with her innocent smile. Priyanka has a great passion for music and dance. This has helped me to cultivate a keen interest in the arts. I strongly believe that we should integrate our children in the mainstream. We need to have empathy to understand the abilities of people with special needs and give them pragmatic training so that employment opportunities open up for them. And integration in the community will always benefit them with a meaningful life. Thank you everyone for giving my daughter Priyanka this golden opportunity to flag off the event and voice out my reasons to celebrate World Cerebral Palsy Day. Wishing everyone a very happy World Cerebral Palsy Day, more strength to our children. Thank you.
My reason to serve as an inspiration and get empathy, not sympathy. You have truly expressed, Padma. Thank you, dear Priyanka and Padma, to flag off this event. Thank you very much. Are you all able to hear, by the way? just raise your hands. All right, thank you so much. The countdown begins to watch the program, a remarkable presentations by professionals from the Spastics Society of Karnataka. Now let's all listen to Dr. M.S. Mahadevia, Honorary Medical Director, Pediatrician, and Pediatric Neurologist at SSK. Dr. Mahadevia has been associated with SSK since 1983. A child-friendly doctor always spends his precious time with children and parents. We will also listen to Maxine Jaws, Maxie, an occupational therapist, head of the therapy services at SSK. Maxie is associated with SSK since 2002, a child-friendly therapist who always interacts with children with his magic smile. A very warm welcome, Dr. Mahadeva and Mr. Maxie.
Okay, so cerebral palsy is no more a condition that one has to have any serious thoughts or pity that we used to have in olden ages, and now a factor that we have to be very proud of their achievements and really be very, very happy that we were part of training them to be functioning at this stage. And like any other father who has a child who grows up and functions in the very best of circumstances and brings pride to his family. I have been dealing with children with cerebral palsy for many, many years, and I have literally seen thousands of them, from the most affected to being most normal. So it's very difficult in the beginning to assess how this particular child is going to function as an adult. So with the advent of so many experts in different fields, so a child with cerebral palsy right from the infancy should be looked at all the aspects, not only physical aspect, but intellectual aspect, behavioral aspect, and see so that we provide him the very best possible therapy throughout his lifetime, and so that he will be functioning normal. And sometimes people with cerebral palsy have much better intellect and functioning than many normal children and adults. So cerebral palsy is no more a condition where one has to look at it as a disease. My experience in all these years, seeing thousands of children and having the pleasure of seeing them grow up and function as adults, and some of them have done so well that I'm very, very proud of their achievements, and it is indeed such a satisfaction. You know, like any other teacher whose student becomes much better than him, much better than the teacher, and goes on to function beautifully in society, is a great honor to the tutor and to the institution where he has been taught.
Good evening to one and all. As we are observing the World Cerebral Palsy Day, I would like to share few information about cerebral palsy, such as what is cerebral palsy, types of cerebral palsy, common associated problems seen in children with cerebral palsy, therapeutic intervention team involved in treating children with cerebral palsy. To start with, what is cerebral palsy? Cerebral palsy is a condition which affects the immature brain, which means the brain is affected at the very, very early stages of the infant, due to which child with cerebral palsy have difficulty in coping up and picking up their developmental milestones. They also have difficulties in movement and posture in their body, and they have increased muscle tone as well as tightness and contraction in their bone joints. Types of cerebral palsy. We have three types of cerebral palsy. Number one, spastic cerebral palsy, where you see increased muscle tone, what we call it as spasticity in the generalized group of muscle in the body. Number two is dyskinetic cerebral palsy, where the children have difficulties in controlling their body movements, what we call it as involuntary movement of the body parts. Number three is mixed CP, where you see spastics as well as dyskinetic CP together in a CP chain. Common associated problems seen in children with cerebral palsy are speech and language delay, intellectual challenges, vision and hearing difficulties, academic challenges, and seizure disorder. Therapeutic rehab team involved in treating children with cerebral palsy are physiotherapist, who takes care of developing their gross motor skills such as sitting, standing, walking, running, and other physical activities. Occupational therapist helps the child in developing the child's hand function skills, fine motor skills, helps the child in better positioning and posturing of the body, as well as facilitating and maximizing independency in their activities of daily living skills. Speech and language pathologist helps the child in developing their communication and speech skills. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Mahadevia and Maxi. We truly appreciate your informative speech. My dear children, parents, and observers, are you all waiting for the overwhelming precious messages by the special parents? Hemavati, her son Gaurav from Indira Gandhi Institute of Child Health, SSK Alumni, and Shashikala, a special educator and parents, Pratik's mother from SSK Sub-Center, and Dr. Shalini Modi, mother of Arjun, SSK CSE. They will speak up their own reasons for celebrating World Cerebral Palsy Day. A very warm welcome to Hemavati, Shashikala, and Dr. Shalini.
Namaste, ನನ್ನ ಹೆಸರು ಹೇಮಾವತಿ, ನನ್ನ ಮಗನ ಹೆಸರು ಗೌರವ್, 11 ವರ್ಷ. ವಿಶ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಸರ್ಬ್ರಲ್ ಪಾಲ್ಸಿ ಡೇ. ನನ್ನ ಮಗ ಅವಧಿಗೆ ಮುಂಚಿತವಾಗಿ ಜನನವಾಗಿತ್ತು. ನನ್ನ ಮಗನಿಗೆ ಸಿ ಪಿ ಎಂದು ತಿಳಿದಿದ್ದು ನನಗೆ 1 ವರ್ಷದ ನಂತರ. ಆಗ ನನಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಭಯ ಆತಂಕ ಆಯಿತು. ನನ್ನ ಮಗನನ್ನು ನನ್ನ ಕುಟುಂಬದವರು ಹೇಗೆ ಸ್ವೀಕರಿಸುತ್ತಾರೆ ಮತ್ತು ಈ ಸಮಾಜದ ಜನರು ಹೇಗೆ ಅವನನ್ನು ನೋಡುತ್ತಾರೆ ಎಂದು ತರಬೇತಿ ನೀಡಿದರೆ ಇಂತಹ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಂತಲ್ಲದಿದ್ದರೂ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ತನ್ನ ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನು ತಾನೇ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳಬಹುದು ಎಂದು ತಿಳಿಸಿದರು. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಮುಖಾಂತರ ತಿಳಿಯಿತು. ಆಗ ನನ್ನ ಕುಟುಂಬದವರನ್ನು ಒಪ್ಪಿಸಿ ನಾನು ದಿನನಿತ್ಯ ನಮ್ಮ ಹಳ್ಳಿಯಿಂದ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿಗೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತಿದ್ದೆ ಥೆರಪಿಗೆ. ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ 7 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ಮನೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಸಂಜೆ 7 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ಮನೆಗೆ ಬರುತ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ತುಂಬ ಕಷ್ಟವಾಗುತ್ತಿತ್ತು. ಈಗ ನನ್ನ ಮಗ ತನ್ನ ಕೆಲಸಗಳನ್ನು ತಾನೇ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತಾನೆ. ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಮಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ನನ್ನ ಸಹಾಯ ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತದೆ. ಈ ತರಹ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿರುವ ತಾಯಂದರಿಗೂ ನಾನು ಧೈರ್ಯ ತುಂಬಿ ತರಬೇತಿ ಕೊಡಿಸಿ ಎಂದು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಹೇಳಿರುತ್ತೇನೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಹಳ್ಳಿಯ ಜನರಿಗೆ. ಆದರೂ ಈಗಲೂ ನಮ್ಮ ಗ್ರಾಮಾಂತರ ಪ್ರದೇಶಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಶಾಪ ಎಂದು ತಿಳಿದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇದು ತಪ್ಪು ತಿಳುವಳಿಕೆ. ಈ ತರಹ ಮಕ್ಕಳನ್ನು ತರಬೇತಿ ನೀಡಿ ಎಲ್ಲರೊಂದಿಗೆ ಬೆರೆಯಲು ಬಿಡಿ. ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮಂತೆಯೇ ಇರುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಜೈ ಹಿಂದ್. ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳು.
My name is Shashikala. I am a special educator at SSK Sub-Center, IGICH. I have a CP child. He is 24 years old. His name is Pratik, who is 100% dependent. When he was 1 year old, he started attending school at SSK Subcenter Seva Kshetra. He had studied till the age of 13 years. Later he moved to FAME India. When he was small kid, he had lot of behavioral issues, like he couldn't sit in one place, he couldn't complete the given task, he used to disturb others. And that time Sumitra ma'am guided me how to control and channelize his behaviors. I followed over a period of time. His behaviors controlled and focused to learn. My husband taught him how to swim. Now he swims in 6 feet deep pool. I have completed special B.Ed. and CP course. Now I am pursuing MEA psychology at IGNO. My son likes car, so I learned driving. Regularly, I drop and pick up my son from his school. Now, I started full day work. My children are at home. I have 13-year-old daughter who feeds him lunch. My children cooperate with me. They understand my feelings and emotions and they take care of themselves. Thank you, my children, and they motivated me to come out and teach other children. Thank you, each and everyone, throughout my journey. Thank you so much. Thank you for giving this opportunity to talk about myself.
Greetings to one and all on the occasion of National Cerebral Palsy Day on October 6th. This day is organized to express gratitude to late Dr. Perin Mulla for her everlasting contribution to the empowerment of people with cerebral palsy. On this day, countrywide celebrations are organized to mark the birth anniversary of the founder president of the Indian Association of Cerebral Palsy, late Dr. Perin. She pioneered multidisciplinary care of people with cerebral palsy in the country. On this day, we need to sensitize the civil society and empower people with cerebral palsy to lead their life with dignity. Me, Dr. Shalini Modi, discovered a whole new world of differently abled people when my son Arjun was born 20 years ago and when I entered Spastics Society of Karnataka. Even though I was a pathologist, I did not know much about cerebral palsy and I had to teach myself and learn about cerebral palsy. How to take care of a child with cerebral palsy and how to deal with the various problems that they have. Various systems in a child with cerebral palsy could be affected. It could be the motor system, the sensory system, their vision. They could have feeding problems, hearing difficulties. A lot of these children have epilepsy and that seems to be the icing on the cake. I think as a mother of a child with cerebral palsy, I was bogged down by all of these things that I had to face. But things were smoothened, my path was smoothened by all the people at Spastic Society who have helped me deal with and taught me how to handle everything. Right from accepting that Arjun is a different child and so everything has to be done differently. My physiotherapists who have been working with him all these years, the occupational therapists, people from the medical fraternity, the ophthalmologists, the neurologists, and the ENT specialist, everybody have been a great help and have been guiding me along. Not to forget the teachers who have worked with Arjun all these years to make him this young, handsome boy that he is today. The immense support that I got from my family is something I cherish and thank God for. My family treats Arjun like a king. My husband actually touches his feet on waking up and before leaving the house. I think it's important to give all differently abled children the same love, adoration, and opportunities you would give a normal child. Bringing up a special child is challenging to say the least. But with the support of friends, family, and society at large, these children can enjoy life as much as we do. Including these children in every part of life, education, fun, recreation, vacation, and helping them participate and do as much as they can do is important. Accepting these children for all their abilities and empowering them to achieve what they want to do will make their lives meaningful and our society to progress. Holding hands and walking with differently abled people is true progress of society. Thank you.
Thank you, Hemavati, Shashikala, and Dr. Shalini for meaningful expressions. What a confidence our parents have got. We really appreciate. Well, millions of reasons. Let's hear from the young achievers who has their own reasons to celebrate World Cerebral Palsy Day. Let it be joyous experiences or challenges. They would like to express the importance of safety, especially the transfer activities, mobility, and access. Here we go.
Today, I am going to speak about accessibility as an inclusion in the society, where in the old buildings like banks and other buildings where they are still are not disabled friendly, like they don't have ramps, and it is very difficult for us to climb and go and talk to people and to meet the managers to having our bank works to complete in the weekends, and it would be very difficult. And if they sometimes don't cooperate and they speak to us rudely and they won't see our difficulties. If there are ramps and other accessibilities, so I request all government buildings and other banks, banking sectors like in Bangalore, to have ramps and other accessibility devices so that we can only go and speak to the managers of our problems to finish our bank works in the weekends. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Hello everyone. On today is a special day, Cerebral Palsy. Well, many people has to be aware what is Cerebral Palsy. So here on this day, I would like to share my few experience which I faced. After my schooling studies, placement when it comes, I have attended many interviews. Due to accessibility, where I went for interview, there were many steps instead of no ramps. And though lift was there, it was very small. And I used mobility for wheelchair, which was not accessible, wherever I go for an interview. So these all difficulties where I faced it. And later on, now currently working in SSK technologies, there where I have a accessibility ramp where I can move on. So on this day, many people should get awareness on what is CPS. Though in my office, they send a mail through intercom to entire office receives a mail about the Cerebral Palsy awareness. So here, on this day especially, I request society to just don't judge a book by cover. So on this day, give us little bit chance. A little chance can make a big difference to entire society. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Lavish, Vinay, and Prabhu for your realistic experiences. Let it be a joy or a challenge. You have your own reasons to strive for changes. Thank you very much. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's listen to Vaibhav, Manjunath, Vipin, and Harsha. They would like to recognize and highlight their achievements and the family and professionals who support them. The young achievers, once again, they speak up their own reasons. Here we go.
Is Vaibhav Adlaka. I am currently a solicitor in a law firm in London. World Cerebral Palsy Day, 6th of October. What does that mean to me? Well, it means a validation of all the great things that people with cerebral palsy have done despite their limitations. It also means that an acknowledgement that 1 in 5 people have disabilities, and we often focus on what they can't do as opposed to what they can. I am possible becomes impossible simply because of our mindsets. If we remove the DIS from our mindset, we'd be able to focus on ability, because I truly believe that with the right environment, right focus, and right encouragement, as well as facilities, anybody can make a valuable contribution. Thus, I hope that today and from this day forward, we commit to focus on finding and encouraging the ability within people. And I thank Spastics Society of Karnataka for giving me this opportunity to be involved in.
Hi everybody, I'm Manjunath Reddy. I work as a lead software engineer for Society General. I am also a person affected, diagnosed with cerebral palsy, and on the occasion of the World Cerebral Palsy Day, I wish to share my experience and my thoughts. I have been associated with Spastic Society of Karnataka since its inception. After a few years studying in Spastic Society of Karnataka, I moved to a normal school. Where I faced few challenges like accessing the classrooms and toilets, and especially going to the school itself. With all these challenges, I completed my education, my schooling. I also studied a diploma in computer science, and after that I moved on to graduating on engineering from MS Ramayya Institute of Technology. Since 2006 onwards, I have been working for several companies. It's been more than 10 years. And at this moment, I wish to tell that technology has played a major role in my life. I use a powered wheelchair where it manages and handles my disabilities, and that is why I'm able to focus more on my career and growth. So I also use voice controlled devices in my house, so I lead a very normal life. Recently I got married to Kanchan. We met in an event where I was organizing, and we liked each other and we fell in love, and with the blessings of my parents, both parents, we are married and we are living a very happy life. On the occasion of the World Cerebral Palsy Day, I wish to say that my friends who are also diagnosed with cerebral palsy, that to follow your heart, follow your passion, and be successful. That way you will be accepted and respected among equals in the society. For the able-bodied friends, I wish to tell them to show more compassion towards persons with disabilities, especially diagnosed with cerebral palsy. As I told you, inclusion and accessibility is not just my need, it is also your need, through which we can, it is important that we have an inclusive mindset towards our community and our society. That way we can live a better life. Thank you everybody for giving this opportunity to share my thoughts. Stay safe, stay healthy. Goodbye.
Good evening to the distinguished gathering. I am Bipin Janardhan, a 41-year-old adult diagnosed as having a medical condition known as diplegic cerebral palsy. I would like to thank Spastics Society of Karnataka for giving me an opportunity to speak on World CP Day to honor the great achievement of people with CP. My friend, this speech will give a glimpse of how determination and power will help us to be a capable contributor in the society. We celebrate World CP Day to celebrate our achievement in every domain and give hope to many aspiring kids with CP to become a purposeful adult who could also contribute to the society they belong. We want to show that we could be a driving force that can make decisions that shapes our destiny. I would like to highlight some of my achievements as a person with cerebral palsy. I was part of the first batch of students to be honored by the Governor of Karnataka in the year 2000. I had the opportunity to be part of a school drama, Ramayana on Wheels, at the Shammukananda Auditorium, Mumbai, which ran to a packed house. I was also invited to be part of the panel representing India at the International Congress of the Persons with Disabilities at Washington, D.C., USA in 2006. Have been a regular participant at the World Disability Day to voice and support the initiatives of the forum. Have been a part of TCS Marathon twice under the Persons with Disability category to highlight the importance of the legislation passed by the government. The achievement highlight the important role we can play in being capable contributors to the success of the disability community. My advice to all parents with CP is to trust the support system given by the professional and guide your child to lead a positive life by helping your child maximize abilities to the fullest capability. Thanks for patient hearing. Thanking you, Vipin.
I am also part of the I cleared my 12th standard in Spastics Society of Karnataka and joined as a data interpreter in an NGO known as AMBA. When I was a child, I couldn't hold anything properly, couldn't walk. Had a problem in balancing. I was drooling and speaking very slowly. I joined school at the age of 10. I learned how to make paper bags and work with computer in school. Now I can work independently on computers and help my sister, niece, mother, and friends at Amba. I am proud working with Amba. We celebrate CP Day to make sure that the government provides job opportunities and facilities like ramps, lifts, wheelchairs, etc. We request all of you to treat us equally without any discrimination. We tell all the parents to love, take care, and train their children to be independent in their life.
Sorry, everybody. Sorry for the small gap. Thank you, everybody, for your powerful speeches. you have your own reasons, which is highlighted beautifully. Now let's get back to leisure times. Leisure activities is equally important, as you all know. You must have heard about the famous saying, all work makes Jack a dull boy. Here we go for an entertainment time. Are you all ready? Shock movie by Anant, Vidini's Birthday Bash, and Nivedita's spectacular piano performance. Here we go.
This is Anant. Cute, isn't he? He has cerebral palsy. Cerebral palsy is a disorder that affects a person's ability to move and maintain balance and posture. To add to that, Anant is quadriplegic and he cannot speak. He is, as a great person once said, an intelligent mind trapped in a disobedient body. This is the ordinary story of an extraordinary man. What makes a person extraordinary? Is it his accomplishments? The way he inspired others? Or is it his perseverance despite all odds to keep on going and strive and struggle in order to live a simple, ordinary life? In the case of Anant, it's the latter. He was one of the first batch of students of Spastics Society of India, which was then run at home with just 5 students. Along with his peers, he moved on to completing his 10th standard exams despite being a non-verbal quadriplegic. How could a person who can't speak or write do his exams? With the help of a wonderful scribe and amazing and motivating teachers and parents. That's how. Who motivated them, other than their own kind hearts? Well, Anant, of course. Despite his physical limitations, he used to make greeting cards and sell them to whoever would buy and would donate that little money he had to an orphanage. He is a born salesperson with a heart of gold. Due to his entrepreneurial spirit, he decided to become a small savings agent, but government restrictions stated that his mother do it in his stead. He still continues to manage those accounts from his computer. Since there is no official school in his hometown of Hyderabad, he's been relentlessly writing to officials for years, urging them to open a school for special kids. He even tried to convince his mother to start a school there like Mrs. Muthu and Poonam Natarajan did in other cities. Luckily, he got to know about Mrs. Sarvalakshmi and the special school she runs in Hyderabad. Since then, it's been his mission to promote the school and help other deserving students receive the care and education they need. Anant is a coin and stamp collector and has participated in many competitions and shows. He attended a camp that allowed special people to do something that others may find impossible. Bungee jumping! He's met Asha Bhonsle, Abdul Kalam and many other prominent personalities. He's an ardent devotee of Sai Baba and continues to live by his principles. So, this is Anant, the simple life of a remarkable man who, despite all odds, continues to strive not to live an exceptional life, but a normal one on his own terms.
Steps hatake agderorge ondu dotta gift nibav home lives instant.
Medine's birthday bash. Let's listen.
I'm not afraid of the dark.
Medini and Anand. End of the day, we all need to be entertained. Thank you so much. Nivedita says with a beautiful smile, her reasons for celebrating World Cerebral Palsy Day is nothing is impossible. And congratulations, everybody. Now, let's get back to the live discussions panel. On the panel, we have Priya Rao, a special educator and associate director. Maxi, occupational therapist, head of therapy services from SSK. Subhashini, physiotherapist and coordinator, therapy department from SSK. And Sujata, a senior speech and language pathologist. Our professionals would like to interact with some of our parents and children and would like to ask them the reasons why they would like to celebrate World Cerebral Palsy. We would like everybody to participate in this, and definitely we would like to listen from every parent and child. Thank you so much. Here we go. The live discussion.
We request the panelists to switch on their videos, please.
Yeah. Priya, I would like to introduce Priya, a special educator and an associate director. She has some a few questions to ask the audience, especially our ex-students. And Priya, let us know, like, what is the reason for celebrating World Cerebral Palsy Day? Let them express. Unmute Priya, please. Unmute Priya.
Sorry, yeah. There are two people here that I would like to ask my question to. One is Avinash. Avinash has done commendable work using technology. So I would like to ask him on this day, what is the technology that you use? And how has it helped you personally in your growth? Avinash, you have to unmute yourself. Santosh, can we unmute him? Avinash, you have to unmute yourself.
Avinash, you have to unmute.
Yes.
Thank you, Avinash.
Sorry. So the question to you is, what technology do you use and how has it helped you in your work and everyday life?
To operate my computer, I use Windows. Speech recognition, which comes inbuilt with any Windows laptop, and to operate my mobile, I use a software called Voice Access, built by Google. it works on Android mobile. In this way, I'm totally independent in using both mobile and laptop using my speech.
Yeah, you've done a series of videos recently, which has been very enlightening to many of us, all of us who've seen it. And thank you for sharing your experience. Just to ask you, what are your hobbies? What do you like doing?
Well, I like reading books. And also, I watch a lot of technological videos on YouTube.
Yeah. Thank you. Avinash also manages the SSK website and all the social media handles. And he's a great team person with some of us who are working with him. Today is the day to thank you, Avinash, for all that you've done for SSK.
Thank you.
Another person I would like to ask a question. He's a boy who's again lived a very normal life, gone through a lot in his life. And this is Suresh. Suresh, unmute yourself.
Yeah. Hi, Ellie, ma'am.
Yeah. So just want to celebrate his life in such a simple way that he has conducted himself. The one question that I want to ask and also share with all of you is that he lives alone. Many parents always fear that after me, what? And here is one person who is living life all by himself in a small house. And he's a security of an NGO and then also doing some work with Amba. An ordinary person, an ordinary life, but a great human being who's taught some of us, who has been his teachers, and even now who interact with him on a regular basis, many lessons in life. And so we need to celebrate Suresh. And I want to ask Suresh,
you know,
ellarige solpa share martiya, nino hege vabne irtiya, ninge yav tara one nimisha.
ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ತುಂಬಾ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಯಾಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ತುಂಬಾ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ ನನಗೆ. ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಅವರೇ ನನಗೆ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು 1992 ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ಗೆ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ರು, ಯಾಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ನನ್ನ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ನೋಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅವ್ರು ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ಗೆ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಟ್ರು. ಆವಾಗಿಂದ ಬಸ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಓಡಾಡ್ತೀನಿ. ನಾ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಒಂದು 5 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಮುಂಚೆ ಮಮ್ಮಿ ತೀರ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರು, ಡ್ಯಾಡಿ ಫಸ್ಟೇ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋದೆ. ಹಂಗಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಅಲೋನಾಗೆ ಒಂದು ಸಂಸ್ಥೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆಲ್ಲ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ. ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ಹೇಳಿ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ನೀವೇ.
ಇಲ್ಲ, SSK ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅದು ನಿಜ. ಆದ್ರೆ ದಿನನಿತ್ಯದ್ದು ನಿಮ್ದು ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರೆ ನೀಡ್ಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದ್ರ ಯಾವ ತರ ಯಾರು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಹೆಂಗೆ ನೀನ್ ಅದನ್ನ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತೀಯ?
ನಾನೇ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಇದೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ, ಅದ್ ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಇನ್ ಯಾರ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದೆ, ನಾನು ನೆನ್ಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ. ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ನಾನು ಇದಾದ್ರೂ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ನ ಬಿಡಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆ ಕೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ನೀನು.
ಹಾ ಹೇಳ.
ನಿನ್ಗೆ ಸಂಬಳ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದ್ ಗೊತ್ತು ನನ್ಗೆ, ಆದ್ರೆ ಅದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ನೀನು ನಿನ್ ಜೀವನ ನಡೆಸ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ತಿಂಗಳು ತಿಂಗಳು ಆಗುತ್ತಾ ನಿನ್ಗೆ, ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀಯ?
ಸಾಲಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ, ಬದುಕಲೇಬೇಕು. ಸಾಲೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಪೇಮೆಂಟ್. ಒಂದ್ ಹತ್ರ 7,000 ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಇವಾಗ ಅಮ್ಮಗಲ್ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಅಮ್ಮಗ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ 2,000 rupees ಕೊಡ್ತಾ ಇದಾರೆ. ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಮಂತ್ ನಾನು ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಆಗಿರೋದು. ಇದು ಫುಲ್ ಸಂಬಳ ಬಂದಿರೋದು 2,000 rupees ಬಂದಿದೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಸಾಲೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಸಂಬಳ ಸಾಲೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಪೆನ್ಷನ್ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಪೆನ್ಷನ್ ಅದು 2 ತಿಂಗಳಿಗೊಂದ್ಸತಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ 3 ತಿಂಗಳಿಗೊಂದ್ಸತಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದನ್ನ ನಂಬ್ಕೊಂಡಿರಕ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನನ್ಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಡೆ ಎಲ್ಲಾದ್ರೂ ಒಳ್ಳೆ ಕಡೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ ಜಂಪ್ ಆಗ, ನೀವ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಕಡೆ ಎಲ್ಲಾದ್ರೂ ಕೆಲಸ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ರೆ ನನ್ನ ಲೈಫ್ ನಾನು ಲೀಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ.
ಅಡಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ನೀನೇ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋತೀಯ, ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀಯ?
ಹೌದು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ನಾನೇ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ. ನಾನೇ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀನಿ, ನಾನೇ ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಕಲ್ತ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಮಮ್ಮಿ ಏನು ಕಲ್ಸಿಲ್ಲ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ, ಮಮ್ಮಿನ ನಾನು ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದ್ರಲ್ಲೇ ಟೈಮ್ ಸಾಕಾಗೋಯ್ತು. ನಾನು ಯೂಟ್ಯೂಬ್ ನೋಡಿ ಅದ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಇದ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಏನೇನು ಗೋಲ್ಮಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಡ್ಗೆ ನಾನ್ ತಿನ್ನೋ ತರ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಅವತ್ತು ಬೇರೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಇಟ್ಟಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾವ ತರ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ.
ನೀನ್ ತಿಂತಿ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಅದೇ ಸಾಕು. ರುಚಿಯೇ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ನಾನು ಅನ್ಸ್ಕೋತೀನಿ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಬಂದು ನಿನ್ನ ಮೀಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಾಗ ನಿನ್ ಮನೇಲಿ ಊಟ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಆಯ್ತಾ?
ಓಕೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು. ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ನಾವ್ ವಿ ಮೂವ್ ಓವರ್ ಟು ಪ್ರಿಯಾ ಅಡುಡಾನ್. ನಾವ್ ವಿ ಮೂವ್ ಓವರ್ ಟು ಸುಭಾಷಿನಿ.
ಗುಡ್ ಈವ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಯು ಆಲ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸೋ ಜಾಯ್ಫುಲ್ ಟು ಬಿ part of this celebration. So I would request your parents to share their experiences in handling CP children in areas like postal care and safety measures. So firstly, I would request Mrs. Liji, who is the mother of 16 years old CP boy, to share her experience regarding the importance of postal care for the children, especially who can hardly move by themselves. And Liji, how were you able to give good postal care at home? Can you please share, Liji?
Yes, thank you, Subhashini, and the entire team of SSK. It's a wonderful opportunity on the World Cerebral Day to share my experiences and a few points on the importance of postural care for children who can hardly move by themselves. In the first beginning itself, I would like to say proper posturing is what is most important in cerebral palsy children. They will be finding it very difficult to move by themselves. But in the movement part of it also, there will be different levels by which each child is different. So each child's posture also needs to be differently cared by the people who are caring for the child or for the adult. Okay, so posture care has to be given to avoid even secondary problems that can later on, as the child grows, can happen, such as scoliosis, pelvic obliquity, hip dislocation and deformed chest cage. That can lead to lung compression and respiratory problems as well. These deformities can cause difficulties in functional decline of their daily activities, and it will be leading to difficulty in maintaining a proper sitting posture or even rolling over a mat. In case a child develops a deformed chest cage, it can lead to decreased respiratory functions as well. So for managing this poor posture, we need to do assistive devices and customized sitting. This poor posture can also lead to abnormal muscle tone in the long run. So children who are hardly able to move themselves are more prone to these kind of deformities. So in order to avoid these deformities, postural care is of utmost importance. So children need external postural care in different positions, for sitting, for supine lining, for side lying, and even for supporting standing. They need different devices or different kind of assistive devices in terms of gaiters and AFOs and all that kind of active devices for helping them to do their regular activities. By providing a customized chair also, a child's need will be taken care of. He will be able to maintain a stable and a symmetrical sitting posture so that the child can use their hands for play, for feeding, for communication, and for learning. And frequent position change is also encouraged, like alternate for every 30 minutes. You can alternate the child in supine lying, inside lying, in prone lying, or in support standing using prone boards and other assistive devices. And I would like to also thank and support for my 16-year-old child. From the time he was 5 years, he was also, he had joined SSK until date. All the support requirements for him in terms of movement, in terms of feeding, transferring, sitting, and all the requirements, SSK, the support team, the therapy department has helped us a lot for finding the correct people to maintain his the posture, for the wheelchair, for the assistive devices, for feeding, and all that. Therapy department has helped us immensely to give us the correct contacts, to give us many inputs from whatever they could, maximum they could try. They have helped us. A big thank you to the entire team of SSK for helping Jaden to become what he is. And as of now, he uses a CP chair that has been helping him, both not even at home for our personal uses, but also for what he requires at school. The management has graciously supported us in all that we need. A big thank you to SSK team.
Thank you, Lizzie. Thank you so much. So my second question will be to Lalita ma'am. Ma'am, would you like to share your experiences, like how you are following the safety measures for transferring in toilets for your son?
Yeah, I basically believe the transfer activities is absolutely essential. The safety rules, what we have to follow, especially when you do when the child is being handled in a bathroom. So what exactly the task analysis a parent has to follow is absolutely necessary. First and foremost, the parent has to make sure the grab bar is being fixed inside the bathroom. If the child is left-handed, make sure the grab bar is fitted to the left side. If it's right-handed, right side. Well, my son Lavish is left-handed. He uses motorized scooter inside the house to maneuver and safety. He doesn't need any safety belt, of course. And before taking bath, he just goes near the bathroom door and gets down from his scooter and grabs the grab bar, which is towards his left side. And I have also put a non-skid mat, which is absolutely essential. This is an awareness for all the young parents to make sure you have a non-skid mat. And number two, weight bearing. If the child is able to do the weight bearing, why not? Don't carry the child inside the bathroom. You have to take care of your back as well, to the parents, I'm saying. Well, Lavish takes few steps to be seated into the toilet seat, and he has a built-in bottom washer. He finishes his task and then moves to the third step. The first step, he goes and holds the grab bar. Second step, he sits in the toilet seat. Third one is he holds the another grab bar, which is being fixed to the left side of him. And then he moves to the bath chair, which is also absolutely essential. You need a suction bath chair inside the bathroom on top of the non-skid mat. And you have a shower where you train your child to mix the shower well, hot and cold, and also brushing teeth. Also, independently, he's able to do. And soon after brushing teeth, he will be able to take his own shower and dry himself totally. Of course, it takes time, about half an hour it takes. It's not easy. But we encourage every child to be as independent as possible. Once he's dried completely, there comes the cushion. The child has no fine motor coordination. So he needs the parents' help. We start dressing him up. He comes out in the reverse direction now. He holds the grab bar two and then goes to the grab bar one and then goes back to his scooter and then gets back to his room. He wheels back to his room where he needs an assistant. And sometimes he can do buttoning and unbuttoning, but most of the time he's dependent because of the time constraint. Basically, the parents are in a hurry. At the same time, they want to finish their task before they leave for their work, or they are also overworked and other things. And then he moves out. So this is also, I would like to say that each child is different. This I'm saying for my child who has a very good weight bearing. I never allowed him to do the weight bearing on myself. I never carried him. I always believe in safety rules during the transfer activity. That is why the video which was shown also, the transfer activity, the steps, how he gets down from a plane. All these steps has to be followed. Thank you so much, Subhashini.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Yeah, you're absolutely, ma'am. It's not only safety measures to be followed for the child, even parents have to follow the safety measures because it is we have to consider the health of the parent, especially mother. They need not have to carry the child and shift the child alone. So whenever the parents feel the child is overweight, definitely parent has to seek for help and see the two person will transfer the child from one place to the other place. That's wonderful, ma'am. Thank you for sharing your experience. Over to Sujata.
Thank you, Subhashini. Sujata.
Yeah, hello. Good evening. My question is to Ms. Dhanalakshmi, mother of Kavin.
Hi, ma'am.
Yeah, hello, hello. Yeah, so my question to you is, as a parent, so what are the possible beliefs you had regarding his communication? As I would take this platform to break the myth that some kind of alternative, augmentative communication or AAC definitely doesn't stop communication but enhances communication. So your opinion on how AAC has improved Kavin's communication, can you please share your opinion?
Yeah, ma'am, sure. Before going to answer your question, I just wish to thank to all your great professionals. Because of that only we are going this mesh level. I'll feel very great to answer this. And before going to that, Kavin, will you wish? Say hello. Ah. Hello, ma'am.
Hello, Kavin.
Yes. Actually, Kavin is a very happy child. Main constraint is about his communication. I want to socialize because he is very interested to socialize to people. So I wish to encourage this beautiful skill with Kavin. So now I'm using that AAC cards. Main thing is when concerned about that radial, let him see that, get that reinforcement. Recently, I've just started using the Jello app, which is having the touch screen. So he is getting that reinforced immediately. For example, simple wishing also, good morning, like that. So, and one more thing, his daily sequencing also is started learning. Like this brushing, all these cards, because using the Jello app, he's finding little difficulty in vision also. So I'm just making this like this picture cards, so which is he can make the choice of him, so he can go and click to that. So now I've just started doing all this training, so it's really helped him. Even now he started that when you ask him the brushing, he's doing that action. So he knows, he's very much aware what is happening with him. That I'm very quite happy with that, following the Jello app under the supervision of Sujata ma'am and the total panel of speech therapy unit. They're helping him how to continue that sequencing also. Not only for Kavin, even for my daughter also, I'm using my Jello app in the daily sequencing. For example, in bathing, now she started that how to close the door. He is now using that sequencing. He started following that all those things in bathing. Almost 80% she finished after using the Jello app. Even he is also following that when he giving that, if I'm asking him what is that after brushing. So he is using that. So brushing, milk. So I'm just preparing according to the Jello app. I'm preparing that picture cards also. He's able to identify. Now he's able to identify also he's doing. And simultaneously, I'm concentrating the words. And he's tried to, now it's vocalized, started vocalizing more regarding that actions. So I'm very happy to using that AAC cards. So actually, finally, what our SSK ma'am is main advice, which is going to be a very transparency, whatever you are doing, and that really the practical goals. That only I'm just main concern to that, so that the people, whatever the children is learning, it has to be generalized. So not only with others, they have to communicate with other people. So that is my main intention. So I'm just very happy to say this Jello app is using very nice to Kavin. And thank you to all.
Yeah, thank you, Dhanalakshmi. Great inspiration. And my next question is to Sukanya, mother of Shreya.
Thank you, Dhanalakshmi.
Can't wait.
Okay. Hi, Sukanya.
Hi, ma'am.
Yeah, so the question here is with regard to hearing.
Shreya.
Hi, Shreya. So with regard to hearing, Iga early identification, Shreyage Igana Vista identified it a little later. So
yes,
in terms of communication or our behavior after identification of the hearing, can you highlight on how it has changed Shreya's communication, and also why is it important to get a hearing screening done at a very early age? So your views on that, can you share? Sukanya Kheli.
ಓಕೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಶ್ರೇಯಾಗೆ ಅವ್ರು ಸಿ ಪಿ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅವಳು ಇಯರಿಂಗ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಸಿರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಅವಳು ಕರೆದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಬಟ್ ಅವಳು ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಹೋಗಿ ನಿತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಸ್ಮೈಲ್ ಮಾಡೋಳು, ಆತ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ಲು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ಅವಾಗ ಅವಳು ಹೆಸರೆಲ್ಲ ಕರೆದಾಗ ಟರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸಿ ಪಿ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ರಿಂದ ಅವಳದು ನೆಕ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಇರ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ನೆಕ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಇಲ್ದೆ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅವಳು ಟರ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ನಾವ್ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡ್ವಿ. ಬಟ್ ಅವ್ಳ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಿತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಸ್ಮೈಲ್ ಎಲ್ಲದೂ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ಲು. ಬಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಕೆಗ್ ಬಂದ್ಮೇಲೇನೆ ಅವಳನ್ನ ನೀವ್ ಹೇಳದ್ಮೇಲೇನೆ ಇಯರಿಂಗ್ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ಗೆ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಿರೋದು. ಅವಾಗ ವೆರಾ ಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ದಾಗ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು ಅವಳಿಗೆ ಇದು ಕಿವಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೇಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇಯರಿಂಗ್ ಏಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ. ಇಯರಿಂಗ್ ಏಡ್ ಹಾಕದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಅವಳು ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಶನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗೆಸ್ಚರ್ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಗೆಸ್ಚರ್ ಮೂಲಕ ಹೇಳಕ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಲು. ಮತ್ ನಾವೇನೇ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಅವಳಿಗೆ ಕೇಳಿಸೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅದನ್ನ ಇಮಿಟೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ಲು. ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಗಳನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವಳಿಗೆ ಏನ್ ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳೋಕೆ, ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹಸಿವಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ಆ ತರ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಹಿಂಗೆಲ್ಲದನ್ನು ಆಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೂಲಕ ಮಾಡಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾಳೆ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ಇವಾಗ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಆಶ್ಚರ್ಯವಾಗೋಂಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಅದನ್ನ ಕೇಳಿಸೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಇಮಿಟೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾಳೆ. ಅವಳಿಗೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಬೇಕಾಗಿದ್ರೆ ನೀಟಾಗಿ ಗೆಸ್ಚರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆನ್ನೆಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೇಳ್ತಾಳೆ. ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾಳೆ. ಇದನ್ನ ಹೇಳಕ್ಕೆ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತೀನಿ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಸುಕನ್ಯಾ ಅವರೇ. ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್, ಓವರ್ ಟು ಯು.
Thank you to your parents and children. That was realistic experience. And many thanks to Priya, Maxi, Subhashni and Sudhata for this live, meaningful discussions. And thank you for your time. Now, ladies and gentlemen, with every person impacted, there is a change that's triggered. And this change will leave a lasting impression on lives. Today, her active involvement has enriched and educated several special educators and empowered many parents. Her career span of 65 years has touched many lives. And this lady who walks tall, she's none other than Srimati Rukmani Krishnaswamy. Ladies and gentlemen, meet the person, Srimati Rukmani Krishnaswamy, Director, Spastic Society of Karnataka, who'll address the gathering and a special thank you message to people with cerebral palsy and their parents.
You have to unmute. Hello, can you all hear me?
Yes.
Okay. First of all, my pranams to all of you this evening, starting from the parents, children, professionals, and those who have created this beautiful program this evening. And if I start mentioning the names, I think I will sort of take so much time. And what we have got today, it's not just listening. What we listen, whatever we heard, is already imprinted in our minds and hearts. And I don't want to stop that feeling to grow and grow and grow and interrupt it at this moment when it is getting settled by my extra talking or sort of saying other things and listing all the names and reading out. I don't think we need that. We are one family. And if you think of us as one family, those formalities may not be quite necessary. But my pranams, I repeat, to all of these children, all of the parents. What have I learned? I have learned a lot. Very often, almost on a daily basis, I tell my family, when you have little disappointments and we complain, don't. I don't think we need to. We can learn. I have learned. I cannot tell you, these are not just simple words or empty words. It's coming from my heart. I have learned so much from you children and parents. I have really learned. I have learned how to strengthen my love. I always had it. But the love you children have, and I cannot tell you, I don't have the words to describe my feeling today. It's not just an emotional outburst here. It is something which has been carved in everybody's heart. I think Spastic Society is known not only for its efficiency. Professionally, we are excellent, no doubt about it. But along with that kind of a professional efficiency and commitment, there is a commitment from the heart. I just do the serving. Like Mother Teresa said, you can have all the things in your brain. When she met me, she said, or she pointed to my head and her head, and she said, you can have all that, and what she meant was you can think you have brain. But she touched my heart and said, you should have a heart for this work. It is not thing you are doing great. That is the duty. Duty to these children, to the parents, and all these people who need us in a small way, which we are doing, not to take to greatly prior. I mean, so we should never feel even for a minute we are doing something so great. I think not with great pride, but that's a natural thing to do. So this kind of a thing is a prayer for us every day, serving these children, parents, and doing our work as professionals, of course, that is there always, but also with a heart. And I think we are getting to be a stronger and stronger team in this whole thing. And ours is a great organization, because not because of only us. It's because these children and the parents made this into a great organization. They made this SSK known to the world. And I think I am again telling you, we will continue. We'll continue our support relentlessly. And let's all be together forever to strengthen the activities of the organization to help more and more children, parents, and ourselves. We're helping ourselves quite a lot by learning certain lessons from these children and parents and everybody around and colleagues. Thank you so much. I just gave a spontaneous stop. And as usual, I don't like to just be very formal during such occasions, which is so very kind of, it's a very different feeling today. It's not only, it's so sacred, and the feeling of humaneness, it gets accelerated during these periods. And I want to keep it as it is. And let this, today has been a great day. The Cerebral Palsy Day has educated all of us, I think, abundantly on aspects of life. Thank you so much.
Mrs. Krishnaswamy, that was truly precious. Special parents and special people with millions of reasons to appreciate you. Thank you very much. And thank you, everybody, for this meaningful presentation. Many thanks to our dear parents, children, participants, and audience for the great efforts behind the stage. And a special thanks to Santosh Padmanabhan, who's always our pillar. It's only together that we can make a grand success. Millions of reasons, World Cerebral Palsy Day, and a happy World Cerebral Palsy Day. Last but not least, there's a surprise. It's going to be aired very soon. Are you all waiting? A thank you message from parents and children of SSK. Please stay tuned.
Doe, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. Far, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow. So, T, tea, a drink with jam and bread. That will bring us back to dough. Oh, oh, oh,
dough.
A deer, a female deer.
Ray.
A drop of golden sun.
Hey.
A name I call myself.
Bah.
A long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow. So, tea.
A drink of jam and bread.
That will bring us back to dough.
A deer, a female.
Well, did you all enjoy the show, everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Was it good?
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much.
Yes.
Yeah, goodbye. Yes.
Lovely program, ma'am. Thank you.
Hi, ma'am.
It is wonderful.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And very happy service. One second.
And
nice seeing you all. Bye, children.
Bye. It's nice to meet so many of you.
Bye, Aarti.
Bye.
It is nice meeting so many of you, really. Especially so.
Thank you, Lalita.
For ages.
Thank you to everyone.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lalita.
Most welcome.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Nice to see all my children.
Good.
Come on, everybody.
Thank you.
Bye, bye.
I know. Nice to see all our children.
Lalita, ma'am, thank you.
Kairali.
Oh,
wonderful nice. Seeing all the children.
Nice to see you all, children. Bye, bye, bye.
So nice.
Thank you very much. It's such
thank
a privilege.
Thank you to all dear children.
Thank you,
ma'am.
Bye,
ma'am.
Thank you. Bye, bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Hi, Harsha. Bye-bye. No. The whole family is watching together. Good. Bye, Mrs. Bye, Mrs. Dave.
Bye, Indra.
Bye.
Bye, Avinash. Oh, nice to see you, Harsha. Harsha's mother, sister, nieces. Lovely.
Family is here. You're all here. I'm his sister.
Yeah, I'm Kairali here. Remember me?
Yes, no. Of course. How can I forget you, Kairali? You're a wonderful person. That's my mother over there.
Yeah, I know. I remember.
My daughter.
These are your kids. So okay.
Yeah, this is my daughter.
No,
yeah, this is Anna. This is Harsha.
Hi.
Both of them. So the whole family is here.
No, very proud of Harsha. Harsha, very proud.
Yeah, it was
very
a wonderful proud. Program and so nice seeing all of you.
So, Lalita has put it together very well.
Very good.
Thank you, Harsha.
Yeah.
Yes. Good to see you.
Good.
Speak all, so all, well, huh? You speak so well.
All our children have grown up in big adults now.
Yeah.
For us, you are still a very small children for us still. Okay. You never grow up for us.
It's so nice to see everybody around Harsha and all of
you.
Seeing all of you after such a long time.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah. And thank you, Prashant.